FTIR and Raman microscopy are powerful analytical techniques in geoscience. They are used widely both in research and in mining, and they help geologists identify and characterize minerals and rocks. Today, we'll explore how FTIR and Raman complement each other in this field and take a closer look at examples of their applications. Let's start with banded iron formations, one of the most iconic and, may I say, most beautiful rocks in Earth history. BIFs are characterized by their distinctive layering of iron-rich and silica-rich bands, which were formed billions of years ago. They are of enormous interest for research as they can serve as an archive of ancient Earth's atmosphere, hydrosphere, and potentially its biosphere. Additionally, these rocks are the biggest source of economic iron on the planet, making them valuable for mining companies as well. Their economic value results, among other things, from their mineralogical composition and from how the minerals are associated with each other. Of course, time is money in the mining business, and because of this, it is essential to determine these parameters quickly and cost-efficient. This is where FTIR comes into play. There is no need for tedious sample preparation as would be necessary in a wet chemical or SEM analysis. And even large sample areas can be scanned quickly, creating a detailed chemical image. Let me demonstrate this with a piece of South African BIF. We simply take the rock section, place it under the Lumos 2 FTIR microscope, and in less than 2 minutes, we can start the analysis. As you can see, the creation of the chemical image only takes about an hour. After the mapping is done, the comparison of the measured spectra with the library allows us to determine the mineral identity. For an analysis of the spatial mineral association, Raman microscopy has been proven to be particularly useful as it can analyze components that are present in small quantities or as inclusions in other minerals. Now you may ask, why not use Raman for the whole area instead of FTIR? With Raman, the measurement would take not only 1 hour, like with FTIR, but more than 2 days. Let us now move to a much faster Raman application. For that, we're moving into the research sector using the Centera 2 Raman microscope. We're going to look at another very intriguing sample from early Earth's history, this sandstone containing ancient microbial mats. Microbial mats are communities of microorganisms that grow in layers on surfaces. They can have a variety of different metabolisms, one of which can produce a very important gas, oxygen. The microorganisms in our sample lived 3.2 billion years ago and might have produced early oxygen. They left behind specific information about the environment they grew in and about the post-depositional changes they went through after dying. Let's have a closer look at how Raman can help in determining the peak temperature that the rock has been subjected to during its long history. For this, we first identify a spot in the sample that is rich in carbonaceous matter. Following this, we carry out a measurement, after which the OPUS software determines the area ratio of the D and the G bands of the carbon, which is temperature sensitive. Finally, the values are inserted into a special temperature-dependent empirical equation in order to quantitatively determine the peak temperature. Our Raman expert D created a Python script for this purpose, which simplifies the temperature determination for you. In this case, the temperature calculated gives a peak temperature of circa 400 degrees Celsius. This high overprint most probably caused chemical changes in the microbial remains that make it difficult for researchers to receive more information about the origin of the organic matter. I hope we were able to show you how FTIR and Raman microscopy can be used to study rocks and minerals. By combining these techniques, geologists are able to gain a wealth of information about the composition of a rock sample, but also about the structure and evolution of our planet. Thanks for watching, and as we German geologists say, Glück auf!